A new era begins today. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Draft Champions. The Broncos enter play this afternoon, ready to see what they've got and how or if these pieces are gonna fit together. Their opponents in this one, the Chicago Bears.
We're underway here. And the tackle is made right around the 26-yard line.
One in the books and all's well. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Draft Champions on EA Sports. The Bears interplay with that first win under their belts, and they look good doing it, too. They'll score off here against the Seattle Seahawks.
This game is underway. He's got a chance to return this one. To be brought down right on. First down at the 33. Running room. Reggie Nelson makes the tackle. First down at the 43. And it's Curtis Lofton who makes the play. Thank you. taking a look at this offense. At 6'4", one of the biggest threats in the game on the outside is Julio Jones.
Yeah, it's just one of those wide receivers, Jim, that can do everything. He can move all over the field. He can catch the tough passes. He can get open. He can run you over. He can run by you. That's why he makes a lot of money.
One-handed catch. Bill, that's one of the best one-handed catches we've seen all year, isn't it?
Jim, that's one of the best. You don't see many this outstanding. And these wide receivers, if they can't get two hands on the football, they've taught themselves over time just to go up and stretch as far as they can and get that one hand on it. And it is amazing how many times they make the catch.
Lamar Woodley able to get to him. He's got the sack.
How about the defense on that play? They were not fooled. They see the pass coming. They get the penetration. They get to the quarterback quick. And that's a big sack down near the goal line.
The Bears with a nickel look here on defense. He'll throw it over the middle. The catch is made by Julio Jones.
Jim, I just want to say this to the quarterback. It's third and goal. If the play's not there, throw it away. Do not force the action.
2 minutes to go. First quarter, third down. Third and goal at the 3. This would be ruled incomplete. Didn't get the feet down.
Well, the defense has got to love that. They love it when a quarterback is uneasy for whatever reason or just not in rhythm. That time they see him throw off the back foot and the throw goes incomplete.
And it's a fake. Reed's in on the tackle.
Well, I like the ingenuity that time. They don't go for the field goal. Instead, they have a run play called. It looks good, but it doesn't work. The defense, fast to react, and he got the job done.
First down, snap, and this is a scary point for them. They'll run it off the toss. Gains 5. Setting the lineups now. One of the absolute best at his position, that would be wide receiver A.J. Green.
Tall, great hands, fast. What is there not to like about A.J. Green? When you talk about your passing game, you must center it around what he can do on the offensive side.
Now first and 10. Brian Hartline has the catch.
That's a good job by the receiver running the drag route across the field. These are not easy throws for the quarterback, but he sticks it right on him for the completion.
First down, offense readying for the snap. Makes the reception.
My gosh, the wide receivers in the NFL now, it's incredible. It's not that we have one. Every team has 2 and 3, and some have 4. Good job that time by him hauling in that pass.
That long gain sets them up here on this play. Smith is in the shotgun. Reaches out and grabs it.
That's what you call a bullet pass. Very little space to throw the football into, but he gets it done. A lot of velocity right on target.
The Bears offense is still out there as we get the second quarter underway. The Bears line up in the pistol offense. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. And the pass is picked by Woodson.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position and they made the interception.
The Seahawks set to take over here on offense, partner, and this team has to have a little chip on the shoulder right now after going for it on fourth down last time deep in the opponent's territory.
Yeah, I hope they have a chip on their shoulders because the defense just flat out whipped them. That's why they didn't get that fourth down attempt. Got to be tough.
The defense gets the sack.
I don't know who to blame here. Was it a great play by the safety getting the sack on the quarterback? Or the quarterback just not paying attention, seeing him coming? And if you see him, you've got to change the play or get rid of the football a lot quicker.
Second down and 13. throws the pass.
Over the middle and incomplete that time.
You got to try to avoid this as a quarterback. Don't throw off that back foot unless you have to. When you do, there's just no way you're going to be as good if you had good balance. That time the throw's off the mark.
Looking across the middle.
Can't find a mark, and this is going to bring up fourth down. Short series this time for the offense. The Seahawks elect to go for it and bypass the punt on fourth down. The Bears go with the dime formation here on defense. Luck's running away from the pressure. The Seahawks turn the ball over on downs.
It is truly a bonus when you can take your outside linebacker and let him rush the quarterback and he can get a sack. Nice job that time by the outside linebacker.
First down and 10.
Underneath, but can't find the mark that time as the pass goes incomplete.
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down.
Smith is in the shotgun. And he comes down.
No, the defender tips it out.
That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
On the way, third down.
Smith's going to take off with it. Running room. Denard's there that time for the tackle.
If you give him the chance, he will run the football. That's what he did that time. He tucked it in there and ran up the field and got a few yards.
First and goal from the 5. Will go ground. In the end, it picks up only a yard.
Nice job that time by the defense. They were ready for the run. Nowhere for the running back to go. And they stopped him for a short gain.
Second and goal from the 4. Smith's on the move. Got a flag. Player showing no restraint, coming in on the quarterback, and that late hit will cost his team 15.
A lot of times these late hits are called, and I feel for the defensive player. Not in this case.
Force it across for the touchdown. And we're halfway through the second quarter. And with the touchdown trip, they are now in front in this ball game.
Man, this game's flying along. We've seen some good play. But that drive right there was not a good job by the defensive front. They were all over the place and allowed the offense to execute some plays and take the lead.
Randall's got it on the toss. And they will not convert here on the 2-point conversion. Good stand by the defense. The Seahawks are in shape now to return the kick. He'll have a chance to take off. He's got a wide open alley. He's in the clear. For the touchdown.
When you get a kick return for a touchdown, a lot has to happen. One, it takes talent by the kick returner, but look at all the good blocks we saw down the field and the speed of the kick returner. Touchdown.
Got the touchdown, got the 2-point conversion. People love to go for two in this game, don't they?
Well, they do. And you know what? Now I guess you and I just can't sit here and blast the coach for a bad decision. When you pick up the 2 points, you can't complain about what they're trying to do.
And they're all over him at the 18-yard line. Timeout's called, and we're going to step aside. Be back in just a moment. The Bears go with 2 tight ends on this play. Randall's got it on the handle. there to make the stop.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
The Bears will take the snap from the 25. Kendricks got it. First down.
Good job of hurrying up and getting on that football and trying to get the play off. Don't use the timeout here. Good clock management. Snap that football.
Second down after the incompletion. Gets the handle here. Randall's tackled down at the 36.
The best way to get more plays in before the end of the first half, go to the hurry-up offense. Nice job by the coach. We'll see if the quarterback can make it work.
Randall's going to secure the handoff. He's averaging about 3 yards a carry on the day.
Nothing like coming up with the stop in the closing minutes of the second quarter and getting that team off the field, Phil.
Yeah, you know, when you get a good stop or do something well as a football team or an offense or defense right before halftime, hey, man, it makes you feel good. You can go in there, enjoy halftime, and get ready for the second half.
And here's the toss. Randall's tackled down at the 43. The Bears use another timeout here, and they have one left. First and 10. And now here's the toss. Holmes able to read that play and make the hit. The Bears elect to take a timeout here before the second down snap.
Almost to the 40 at the 39-yard line.
Second down and a long way to go. Goes deep to A.J. Green, but it's incomplete.
Well, we still got a close game here, and you got to try to keep it that way. It's third and long, and you're losing a football game. Don't take a chance on the offensive side. Wait for your next opportunity.
From the gun. Smith's going to scramble. Has to hurry the throw. Catches the ball on the sideline, but does not get both feet down. The Bears will risk it here, going for it on fourth down.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
The Bears turn the ball over on downs. What will be the mental makeup of this team after the half, Phil, as that fourth down attempt goes against them?
Well, I think they're all going to go in halftime. And you know what, Jim? They're going to be mad about one thing. They're going to be mad at the coach because he's the one that decided to go for it on fourth down. It could come back and be one of the big plays of the game.
First down at the 39. Taking off. Luck tackled down after a gain of 5. The Seahawks call a timeout and are left now with only one.
At the line of scrimmage, the 34.
Second down and 5. It's wide open.
Good job that time by the ball carrier, picking up what he can, and he is very smart. Gets out of bounds and stop the clock.
First down at the 21. To complete that one. So second down here. Quarters formation here for the defense.
for the sack.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit here. You want to stop the offense from scoring here with under 2 minutes to go in the first half. Good pressure on the quarterback, and they take it down behind the line of scrimmage.
All right, Larry, thank you for all of those updates. And now the teams are coming back onto the field, and we're about to get the second half started. The second half is officially underway. They're setting up the return. And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. The Bears offense trots out onto the field, looking to get into the end zone and see if they can turn the tide in this one, partner.
Well, the fact that they are losing this game so far, the sense of urgency is there on the offensive side. You know, you have many plays in that playbook. I think they need to try a few different ones here in the second half.
An extra tight end on the field for this one.
First down at the 19.
Fakes the throw. Still has it. Ball is out. And the recovery is made by the defense.
Just out of the half, and it looks like the coaching staff's adjustments worked as the defense comes up with the fumble recovery.
Yes, I like what the coach... Offense by surprise, and they got the turnover.
Great starting field position for the offense.
The Bears defense now is going to go nickel. First down at the 24. Locks on the move.
Second down following that incompletion.
Look at the defensive line. Everybody spreading out. I think they're going to try to pressure the quarterback.
With two hands, he has it. And he'll step out.
Well, I guess the best thing to say there, Jim, is they completed the pass, but it still did not get a first down.
Looking at third down. They'll run it here. Muscles through the defender. That's a good tackle, and that's a quick three and out.
The Seahawks offensive coordinator, he has to be frustrated by that play. I think he calls the right play, but what happens? The run loses yards. That's just a bad job of the offensive line.
The coach is going to go for it. The Seahawks get set at the line, needing to get to the 14 for a first. Luck going to try to scramble now. Throws it in the end zone. Touchdown.
Nice throw by the quarterback that time. Put it right on the money. Not a big window. It doesn't matter to him today. Great control of the football. Put it right in there for the touchdown.
The Seahawks now lined up for the extra point. He made it. The Bears are ready to return the kick. He'll take it from the one. Tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. The Seahawks defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. He'll go nickel. Randall's taking the handoff.
The Bears running back that time, he makes a bad decision. You can't be looking to make every play a big play when you're running the football. Look for a few yards, take advantage of that. He tries for the big play. What happens? He gets tackled for a loss.
Loss of three on the play.
Second and 13.
The pass complete to Hartline.
third long situations, a lot of coordinators in this league will run a draw play on third long. Why? Because they're just looking for field position, pick up a few yards, and then by some miracle, if the running back's able to make guys miss, break some tackles, and pick up a first down, man, that's just great.
Joseph Randle with the reception.
You know, as a quarterback, sometimes you got to trust that arm and throw the football past the first down marker. There were guys open, but no, he takes the safe route, throws it short, defense makes the tackle, and here we are staring at a fourth down. Good job by the defense that time. Fourth down, they were ready for everything. Very aggressive, fast. They make the play, and this could change the game around.
Midway into the third. Going deep. Intercepted.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
The Bears back out there on offense. Their last drive, they had fourth down on their own side of midfield. They decided to go for it. Instead of punting the football away, we both were wondering why.
Oh, man, some people just never learn. They keep going for it on fourth down when they're in their own territory, and it always backfires. And what do you expect? Well, I know what you can expect, another loss. You just got to be smart with your decision-making when you're managing a football game.
Woodson's going to take this one from the 18. Keeps his legs moving. Woodson's marked down at the 41. That return's good for about 22. The Seahawks could have asked for this third quarter to have gone any better for them than it has so far, as they've just continued to do what they were doing in the first half, up and down the field.
Oh, man, they kept the pedal to the metal, man. They are letting it go. They're being aggressive, and they're trying to end this game right here.
Intercepted by Reggie Nelson.
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled. Being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did. They got the interception.
The Bears from the 27. Randall's going to take the handoff now. Second and 8 coming up. The Bears have it at the 29.
Wide to the left.
Randall's brought down after picking up only a yard.
Randall's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
The Seahawks lined up in the nickel.
Look out, they're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
The story of this game, third down failures today. That's what happens when you try to guess the snap count.
The Bears do a good job that time on second down. They don't force the football down the field. They throw it short. They pick up some solid yards to make it a good situation for them. Third and short.
Third down and 2. Trying to plow ahead.
Randall's trying to find a way to pick up that short yardage situation on third down, but the defense does an outstanding job, on especially the defensive line. Nowhere to run and no first down.
The Bears have decided now to go for it on fourth down and a short yardage situation. The Bears from the 37 takes it out of the eye. The Seahawks have done a whale of a job taking their halftime lead and adding a whole lot more to it here in the third quarter.
And they're just doing everything we saw them do in the first half, just dominating the pace of play and just being more physical than the defense.
First down at the 35. Lutz unable to find his target that time.
Well, you want to put all the pressure on the quarterback to make really good throws down the field. Play tight man-to-man coverage. It takes perfect throws to get completions. Not there that time.
Second and 10. Incompletion here as he was looking over the middle.
Sometimes on third and long from the defensive side, I like the fact that you can blitz. Send more guys than they can block. Make the quarterback throw the football quickly and short.
then it's all up to coming up and making the tackle.
The Seahawks have to get to the 25 to move the chains. Luck, handoff.
We're getting started with the fourth quarter. Jim Nance and Phil Simms here for the call.
Walsh set now to attempt the field goal. Not enough leg with that one.
Now, moments like this, you're on the sideline, the field goal kicker comes off the field. Well, you just turn your back and walk away because you don't want to yell at him. You've driven the football down the field. He goes out there and kicks it and doesn't hit it well enough to even get it over the crossbar.
The Bears will take the snap from the 40.
Wants to go deep.
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down. Smith is in the shotgun. Knocked down as he fires it. The Bears continue to try to look for answers in the passing game. Smith's been trying to battle through some tough spots, but he's been up and down today.
That's what you have to do as a quarterback. You said the appropriate word, battle. The quarterback, keep battling, stay with it, and hope you can turn things around.
Third and 10. Unable to complete that one, and that's a very quick three and out. Fourth down and 10, and they're going to go for it. Randall's lined up behind his quarterback as the single back. Smith's now going to leap. The Bears turn the ball over on downs.
Outside linebackers who can get to the quarterback, they are a rare breed in the NFL because it takes talent, size, speed, everything to do it as a linebacker, and we saw it that time on display.
First and 10. And Carey is able to grab it. Carey's taken down at the 26. Defense calls a timeout.
When you play zone in the NFL, what you're trying to do is make the quarterback hold the football just for a half a second longer, and you hope the pass rush can get there. They don't that time. That's why he got the completion.
From the shotgun. He's got the catch. Gets about 4 yards that time. And there's a timeout, so we'll take one with them. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The Seahawks come out with a split backfield. Third and 6. The Seahawks get a first down. And the timeout is called, so we're going to take a quick break and return in just a moment.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
And it's batted down.
Gets tight down here in the red zone. So if you're a defender, read the quarterback, you make a quick break on the football, hey, you get in position like this, you can knock it down.
Coming up to the line at the 14. Second down and 10. Luck's taking off. Reed's there to take it down.
Well, we just don't talk about it enough. He is so good, has such quick feet. And then when he gets outside, if you make him run, he will. And a good job there picking up some extra yards.
Third down on the way. And now his surge ahead. The The offense back out on the field here for this fourth and short play.
Look at the defensive line shifting all down to the inside. They're pitching. They're expecting a run right up the middle. The Seahawks absolutely did not need to go for it on fourth down here in the second half when they're leading. But let's give a lot of credit to the defense. That was a tremendous play to stop the offense.
First down now in a dangerous spot here. The Seahawks with a nickel look here on defense. They'll go draw. James Laurinaitis brings him down.
Randall's never able to build up that power that he has as a running back when there's nowhere to go.
Hey, there's nowhere to go. That's a short game.
Midway through the fourth quarter. Launches it down the field. One-handed. Makes the grab. And now we reach the two-minute warning. Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way. This play set up by the long gainer. Back to the air here on first down. But the hit knocks the ball out.
Good timing by the defensive player that time. He gets to the receiver just as the football is getting there and makes the hit, knocks that football loose.
Second down coming up. Time, obviously, a factor the rest of the way. The Bears take it from the 43. And that'll probably go as a drop.
So many times when you drop a football in the NFL, a pass like that, it's because of lack of concentration. You're just not serious about what you're doing.
On third and long, they'll be in four down territory here. The Seahawks come out in a dime package. The Bears take it from the 43. Smith's running away from the pressure. That was Woodson on the coverage that time.
The Bears put themselves in a situation where the defense has all the advantage. They know the pass probably has to go down the field on third and long, and they were ready for it.
Crucial play here. Fourth down on the way. Makes the catch. It's wide open. Woodson's there to make the tackle. First down. Pressure on every snap now.
Well, there's just no other option for the offense right here. They got to go to the hurry up because they have no timeouts left. So get as many plays off as you can.
Touchdown. This game is tight. They're back in the game with that touchdown. It's a one-score game, but they're going to need a lot of help because time is running out.
It is enough time to get the football back for your offense. Let's see what happens. The 2-yard line now in the NFL. All the teams can spread you out. They can run it. The quarterback can keep it. The big plays, the passes, very tough for the defense to stop the 2-point conversion.
That's the way you get back into the game, picking up the 2-point conversion. There's a flag right there. They have been fighting an uphill battle, and they had to recover that onside kick.
Well, it was a tough spot for him, Jim. We know that. When you're going for the onside kick and you're trying to recover it, I think your chances are about 1 out of 10, and that time it was not on their side.
Now first and 10. Has space. Ball is out. After nearly turning it over, it's second down. Got a big lane. Luck's brought down after picking up 14 on the play.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score. Again, you have a small lead late in the second half. Why would you be in the hurry-up offense? Doesn't make sense to me.
quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
Luck slides and ends the play.
It's not as easy as it looks. That quarterback, good job of sliding before he takes the hit that time.
Time continues to tick away as they'll rush back to the line. And it's good. In the waning moments, this should all but give them the win.
That may have been the clincher right there.
Yeah, what a game all day long. So exciting to end it like this late in the game. Man, you enjoy victories like this.
Makes the PAT. The Bears are ready to return the kick. And he'll start his return. Steps out of bounds. And a run back of about 17. The Bears' offense comes onto the field for a last play or two before this one's over. There's nothing they can do now to pull this one out for.
Yeah, listen, it's very tough to even get the courage or the energy to finish this game off in a situation like this because it's so disappointing. And I say to them, don't take any chances. Don't get hit again and just get off the field.
Second down after the incompletion. Hartline's got the grab on the touch pass. Denard's in on the tackle. The Seahawks decide to take a timeout here, leaving them with only one. That was a big gainer. Now it's time to pack it up. He was looking short, but the pass falls incomplete.
Well, Phil, I enjoyed watching the game with you, and how about a final thought about that victory?
Well, you know, Jim, I wish I could say the same that I enjoyed spending these last 3 hours with you, but that's just not the case. But, no, just kidding, of course. Nice win. They got to feel good about what they've done and celebrate a little tonight.
I think I'll see you next week, maybe.
For Phil Simms and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nance saying so long for now.
We've just gotten started here, and already these guys have been handed a really difficult decision to make. Russell Wilson, the selection at quarterback. Cerebral, accurate, effective in and out of the pocket. He's the perfect choice to be the leader of this offense and the face of the franchise. Oh, though, no question that this guy's going to grade out as a huge impact over what was there before. Interesting choice. I think the question you have to ask, though, is he the right guy for the system they're planning to run? Oh, and that's a key upgrade right there. He's versatile, athletic, and a big upgrade over what they had. Still some big holes remaining to be filled. Here's where you may have to go after a lower... Yeah, I think with that pick, you're just looking to build up your core. Get some guys in here that can help round out the roster. And this is the cream of the crop here. A five-star round all the way. Oh, I tell you, you're not going to get too far in this competition without a superstar or two. And this guy right here certainly fits that billing. I know we'll do it again. I know we're going to collide. I know we'll call it the end. It's always, always a lie. You wear your heart on your sleeve. I wear my blood on my tie. But it's only love underneath. It's the sky. Oh, you Now it's getting to the time of the draft where you really want to get lucky and hope somebody falls into your lap. Boy, a tough choice here, but one that any organization would love to have. How do you go wrong with these three guys? Where to now? Do you get yourself a big brute for the trenches or someone who can really help you out at a playmaker type spot? The Panthers have been represented once already in this draft. Is a second about to come off here? Go wrecking something of mine. Like you deserve the revenge. Like I got something to hide. I'll keep on playing with you. These are tough decisions here. Offense or defense? Which side has the more pressing need? Now that is quite a threesome. If only every round were this well stocked. And give these guys credit. They came into this draft with a plan, and they've really stuck to it.
Begins today. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Draft Champions. The Bears interplay this afternoon, ready to see what they've got and how or if these pieces are gonna fit together. They'll square off here against the Carolina Panthers.
And with that kick, we're underway.
Patterson's going to start his return. And he's going to be brought down right around the 33-yard line. Wilson comes out in the pistol. The Panthers' defense now is going to go nickel. Wilson's going to take off with it. Wilson's met after a gain of 8.
That's an excellent job by the quarterback getting a few yards there with the run. You know, when you play against him, of course, anytime he drops back to pass, you've got to be alert for the run.
Second down and 2. And it's out of bounds, incomplete.
One player to watch is the tight end who revolutionized his position, Jimmy Graham.
I'm not going to argue with that statement, Jim Nance, because you are right. I don't care if he's a tight end or a wide receiver, he's great at both.
Dwayne Harris hauls it in, and he races out of bounds at that point.
If you got a defensive back that's scared to death and not going to give up the big play, you've got to run things like this. The out route, nice route by the wide receiver, and a good throw by the quarterback.
First down at the 47. Makes the catch in open space. Going to take it the distance. Going to take it home for the touchdown. Phil, what a way to make a statement by scoring so early in this game.
You know, Jim, I love making statements, and that's what this team did. They went out there and told the opposition, we are better, we're tougher, and take that.
Ball was out. The defense has the football. Could have taken the 1-point gimme. They went for the 2, and they are turned away. Picks up the football at the 6. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Panthers at the line of scrimmage with their set of receivers in a bunch formation. First down at the 23. Sanu makes the grab. The Panthers now move the chains. How about the way he always locks in and concentrates on the catch?
And he's got hands like glue. When you shake his hand, he can break yours because that's how strong they are. So not surprised to see him just reach out and just snatch the football out of the air.
Matt with the sack.
That's an awesome job by the outside linebacker. Gets a sack on the quarterback. And nowadays, you've got to do it all if you're an outside linebacker. You've got to be tough against the run, cover receivers down the field, and yes, plays like that get to the quarterback.
The Bears defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. The Panthers from the 27. Slashes to the left side. And picks up maybe 3 or 4. The offensive lineup includes tight end Julius Thomas, a former college basketball player at Portland State.
Yeah, how about that transition? He plays 1 year of football at Portland State, becomes a 4th-round draft pick, and then he just has an outstanding year in 2013.
No one's going to get him now. He's brought to a halt.
What a nice throw and catch that time, but here just shows you why you want to have a lot of speed on the defensive side. So when you make a mistake, what do? You make up for it by chasing the player down from behind and making the tackle.
Coming up to the line at the 13.
After the long gain, let's see what they do here. Newton's going to take the snap from the shotgun. And now he'll take off. That picks up 7.
Well, he has such a good arm. That's all we talk about. We never talk about the fact that when he has to, you make him, you force him out of the pocket, he'll run with that football and get some yards.
Duke, handoff. And that'll be a gain of about 2. this defense today. The former first-round pick out of the University of Houston, D.J. Hayden.
Yeah, went through some injuries in 2000. Expect him to come back with all that talent and be one of the best corners in the NFL.
Ready to take the snap at the four. That defensive front looks impenetrable here on the goal line.
First down by the offense in the red zone, and, you know, if you're on the defensive side, you don't have to worry about deep passes anymore. You can be more aggressive and take some chances.
The Panthers on offense here to start the second quarter. They come to the line, and it's first down. And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
This will be the eighth play of this drive.
Second and goal from the four. The one who made the big stop.
When you get third goal, a lot of times it just comes down to who's willing to fight the hardest. We'll find out here in a second.
Third and goal from the seven. And they get the sack. Players from both sides making an appeal, but the officials saw it on the defense.
Breaking huddle at the four.
Defense ready in the goal line formation on this one.
Third and goal from the four.
And now Newton's going to take off. Takes it across. It is a touchdown.
In today's game, you know, Jim, you always have to be alert in situations when the quarterback drops back the pass. You've got to think he might be able to run out of the pocket. And that time, the defense got alert for it. Nobody's there, and he scrambles in for a touchdown.
The Bears are ready to return the kick. Harris elects to run it out. Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21.
The Bears offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim, but you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
Well, the defense has got to love that. They love it when a quarterback is uneasy for whatever reason or just not in rhythm. That time they see him throw off the back foot, and the throw goes incomplete.
Wilson's back in shotgun formation. Got hit on release.
Well, but it's third long. I'll just say this. Be very careful on the offensive side.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. The Bears will line up the first down markers right at the 31-yard line. For Darryl Patterson with the play. It's the old Marino play. A fake spike and looking to throw. Leaps in the air and has it. That's his first reception today.
You saw why defensive backs can't sleep the night before the game when they play against this quarterback. Beautiful, long throw down the field for the big completion.
It's a spike. No, it's a fake.
Coming up to the line at the 11.
Wilson's got two tight ends on the field for this snap. Khalil Mack takes down the quarterback.
That's a bad job by the offense that time. There's no doubt about it. The blitz by the defense, they do not do a good job of finding out where everybody's blitzing from. They let a guy come free, and that free blitzer, or as we call them, free runners, he gets the hit on the QB and takes him down.
Wilson standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. Kenny Vaccaro in on the interception.
He's got a little bit of daylight here. And he's brought to the ground.
Wonderful job by the defense that time. They stayed after it. And inside their own 20, they finally come up with the play. They get the interception, and they keep the other team from getting points on the board.
First down at the 36. Newton's on the move. Breaks free. Breaks out of the tackle.
Well, there's under 2 minutes to go. Good job by the offensive ball carrier that time. He knows he can get no more yards. He steps out of bounds to stop the clock.
Set up now at the 46. First down at the 46. Ball is out. Recovery by the offense.
One thing coaches hate when their offense is on the field is fumbling the football, because a lot of times it's just bad fundamentals. But they're lucky this time they have the fumble. They're able to get on top of it.
The Panthers have it at the 44. Sanu with the catch. It's third down coming up.
I like this decision by the coach to go with the hurry-up offense here late in the first half. You can't be worried about making mistakes. Sometimes you got to be aggressive. Well, it's a great feeling, isn't it, for an offense to throw a short pass to the running back and get a long gain. This guy is in there because he can run it, he can catch it, and he can make things happen.
Newton's 4-for-4 with that completion. Incomplete.
Got to try to avoid this as a quarterback. Don't throw off that back foot unless you have to. When you do, there's just no way you're going to be as good if you had good balance. That time the throw's off the mark.
The Panthers will take the snap from the 25.
And it's caught by Marshall Faulk.
Gains 19.
Well, I think we're seeing something we see with so many teams now in the NFL. Running backs who can do it all. This guy can run, block, and he can catch short passes.
And he's taken down.
You got to be quick and decisive when you're down near the goal line and you're throwing the pass as a quarterback. That time he was not, and he takes a huge sack.
Second down now. The Bears lined up in the nickel. Cam Newton takes it from the shotgun. The Panthers have to take their final timeout. That's it. One more snap, and we'll head to halftime. Third and goal from the 10. Intercepted! We're headed to the half here in a tight, low-scoring defensive battle. I'm sure both teams will be making adjustments offensively coming out of the half. Larry Ridley's coming up next. With this kick, the second half is underway. And this is Ginn running it out. He steps out.
What a job by the kickoff team. The hustle. Everybody sprinting down the field, and they get rewarded. They give great field position to their defense.
The Panthers will try to hold on to the football. This has been one big turnover after another, Phil. Just what the coaches talked about in our meetings with them this week about ball security. It's not happening here.
Well, it tells you the players did not listen to the coaches, that's for sure, because ball security is not what we're seeing out there. I know this. Next week in practice, there's going to be a lot of drills about hanging on to the football.
He's got some daylight. Gains 17.
That's what you want to do. Get a first down while you're on top and keep that clock moving and just controlling the football game. Good job by the offense managing things so far here today.
First down at the 43. And now they'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play. They're going to the hurry. To the ground. Picks up eight here.
The Panthers' offense has been tough today. They are fighting out there on the field. That's a nice job picking up that first down. It's been fun to watch. They got a small lead here in the second half. We'll see if that first down can lead them to a score.
Newton's brought down after picking up 14 on the play.
I don't think we realized how good of an athlete he was coming out of college. We never talked about his running ability, but since he's been in the pros, we see him run pretty good at it.
Randall's shifted out wide to the left as a receiver. Smith can't bring it in. That'll probably go as a drop.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position, nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
The Panthers will take the snap from the 25. The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. The Panthers at the line of scrimmage, split backfield. Halfway through the third quarter. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down. They're going to go for it here on fourth and seven. The Panthers will line up. First down markers right at the 15-yard line. The Panthers take it from the 23. The Panthers turn the ball over on downs.
Well, when you're winning in a tight game in the second half, I don't know about going for it on fourth down. That was a big decision. It could come back to really haunt them.
Loss of two on that play. First down at the 25. Down the field. Nice catch. Inside, and he's home for the touchdown.
Boy, just think about what it takes. It takes a quarterback with a talented arm to make this type of throw, and it takes a talented receiver to make this catch. They do both, and it results in a nice touchdown. They wanted more excitement, more tension, more decision-making. It's the second guess in the NFL, and now they're going to have it. This two-point conversion, more teams are going to do it because they don't want to kick the extra point from the 15-yard line.
Lester's going to make the tackle. That return's good for about 21. The Panthers taking the field again on offense. They paid the price for an aggressive decision on their last possession, passing up on the field goal attempt and going for it on fourth down, then coming up short.
Yeah, look, no second guessing for me on that. I'll just say this. I'll give the defense a lot of credit. They were there. They were ready for the situation.
A foot race to the end zone. The 30, the 20, the 10. All the way home and all alone. Touchdown.
Short passes are just as important as the long passes down the field. This time, a short, accurate pass. Look what it leads to. All those yards after the catch. Nice run, nice catch, touchdown.
The Panthers can tie it up with the point after. The point after try is in the books. Everyone's lined up for this kickoff.
Will test the coverage.
And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line.
The Bears taking the field on offense, coming up a touchdown on their last drive, Phil.
Yeah, they did it mostly through the air, Tim, and I love the way how they did that. It was aggressive throwing by the quarterback, and my gosh, is he on target today.
Oh, it almost picked off that time. Failing to complete that one. So, second down here. Wilson's got it in the gun. Looking to go down the field here, but it's incomplete.
Quarterback has a strong arm, but I am starting to question his touch. Need a little more touch on those deep passes. That time he overthrows the receiver.
The Bears need to get to the 35 to pick up a first. Slashing to the right side. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
The Bears decide to go for a run here on third long. And look, not second-guessing that play call. Not fitting the playbook. In the passing game, they're going to pick up a first down. They go with the run. The defense is not fooled. And now we're going to punt.
The Bears turn the ball over on downs.
Well, anytime you run a fake punt and you let somebody throw the football besides the quarterback, even though the play is there and everybody's wide open, you still have a chance of not making it work. Why? Because the guy throwing it is not an NFL quarterback.
And that gains a few. Second down here after that run play. Getting set as fast as they can. From the gun, Newton. He'll throw it over the middle. Two hands on the football and has the catch.
That's a really good throw and catch, and they get the first down. Jim, that's what you want to do. Pick up that first down. Now you give your offense three more opportunities. Well, when you have a tie game and you're down in the red zone, you can do whatever you want. You can fool them with a run here, or you can take a chance and throw the football in the end zone to get a score.
Now they'll try over again on second down. The Panthers all bunched up here as they get set at the line. In his hands, complete, touchdown. Phil, they come out and start the fourth quarter with a touchdown that gives them the lead.
Man, what a way to start the fourth quarter. What a feeling. Anytime you're ahead when the fourth quarter comes in a football game, that's a great feeling. And once again, it puts the pressure back on the other team.
Harris is going to test the coverage here. And that return ends rather quietly, short of the 20. Let's mark him at the 16. The Bears' offense is back on the field, Phil. Of course, their last drive ended with that very curious decision to go for it on fourth down their own territory.
Well, I just wonder, what is it with the coach that he just hates the word punt? Because it was an obvious punting situation, and you go for it, so you're going to pay the price for making bad decisions.
Yeah, what were they thinking there?
Well, Jim, we'll never know, and I don't know if I want to know.
Second down coming up. Russell Wilson has it under center. Smith got the toss, secures the football. Smith marked down after a gain of 9. We'll go no huddle. Third and 1. Here's the quick toss. And he's going to be tackled. And that's going to bring us to fourth down.
There's a fine line there when you're winning the football game. What do you do on the defensive side? Well, that time, the defensive coordinator stayed aggressive. And he forces a fourth down by the offense.
The Bears will go for it here on fourth down and short. The Bears take it from the 23. The Bears turn the ball over on downs.
Well, what the coach is trying to do, he's trying to give his team a lift. They're down. It's fourth and short. They go for it, and there is no lift there. The offense doesn't come through. Now you hope your defense can come out and stop it.
First down at the 24. Newton over to Steve Smith. That was a nice reception, but not enough for the first down. Second down coming up.
Stepping up to the line of scrimmage, the 22-yard line.
The clock's really become a factor here, and the defense knows it has to get off the field as soon as possible to give the team a chance. Newton's tackled down after a gain of 15.
Jim, the offensive coordinator's done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
Mayo wraps him up.
Now, this is about as bad as it gets for a quarterback in a situation like this. You're near the goal line, and they give you a chance to throw the football, and you take a sack. Oh, my gosh. I wouldn't want to be him in that film session tomorrow.
Loss of 5 on the play. Leading and with possession of the football, a good place to be at this point in the game. And
handoff out of the I formation. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry.
Jim, I love these situations. Third and goal, what are they going to call? They're going to run the football, they're going to go with a pass, and if it is a pass, I would look for something quick.
Only 1 yard remaining. The defense loading up. They jam it in on the goal line. Touchdown.
You got to be able to take advantage of the quarterback sneak. If the defense doesn't line up properly, find the weak spot and go there to score.
Oh, he actually misses the point after. The Bears are ready to return the kick. Patterson's going to run this one out. On his way. The 30, the 20, the 10. Nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown.
You can never talk enough about special teams in the NFL. It truly is a third of the game. And when you get a kick return for a touchdown, that just gives you so much momentum. Look at the blocks. Look at the speed of the returner. Great job. Leads to a touchdown.
The Panthers are prepared to return the kickoff. He'll take it from the 4. Able to move past the 20 and brought down at the 23. The Panthers coming back onto the field on offense. They took it down the field for a touchdown the last time they had it.
Listen, momentum is on their side. When you have that going for you, keep the defense guessing at what you're going to do. So I think it's very important to stay aggressive in this situation.
Double tight end formation.
Falk has the catch out of the backfield.
Well, we see it more and more. Football thrown behind the line of scrimmage. They do it that time. Nice catch, but a loss of yards on the play.
Loss of 5 on the play. Coming up, second down. Halfway through the 4th. Falk has the catch out of the backfield. 2 minutes. 2 minutes remaining in the game. Third down. And here's a sneak by Newton. They bring in the extra tight end.
The D-line saw something on the offense. Everybody shifted to the left.
Had it for just a second, but then it came out on contact.
Thomas is one of those guys. If he drops a pass or makes a mistake on the field, he doesn't make excuses. He knows no matter what the circumstances are, if you get your hands on the football as a receiver in the NFL, everybody expects you to make the catch.
The Panthers take it from the 33. And now Newton's going to take off. Feet first, gives himself up.
Good job that time by the quarterback sliding. The team, you are valuable to them. Throwing the football, not running. Slide before you take that hit.
It's going to be a delay of game penalty.
Newton takes a look now from under center. First and 15. Pass is intercepted. So how about that, Phil? The defense comes up with the interception to give the team a chance.
Jeff, I'm not going to second guess the play call. I thought the offense was trying to make the play to get rid of the game, to ice it, to get it over with. Well, give the defense credit. They came through with a great play.
The Bears get ready to snap the football. They must be careful. They have no timeouts to play with. Now on first down, every snap crucial the rest of the way. He makes the catch. That's a gain of six. The Bears still trail, but as we look at the passing numbers, it's hard to find much fault with them. Wilson's tried to keep his team in it any way he can.
Well, a couple things, Jim. You can't blame the quarterback because of trailing. He has been outstanding here today. The offensive line, the play calling, all good.
Tries to get the feet down, but this will be ruled incomplete. So coming off an incomplete deep pass, there just aren't that many plays you can call right here when you're desperate.
No, there's not many. And look, you got to throw it down there. You got to hope for your skilled athletes to make the play. The defense was ready that time. I expect another deep throw on this upcoming play.
Wilson's going to scramble. Fourth down is on the way, and to the surprise of no one in this stadium, they're going for it.
Yep, and you know who's going to win this battle? The toughest, most physical team. That's what the NFL is all about.
The Bears will walk to the line. They've used up their timeouts at this point. Back at the line. They're going for it on fourth. Wilson's on the move. Looking to go deep. And they can't connect. Wilson's inability to produce the conversion on fourth down in all likelihood signals the end of their last chance to win this game.
In situations like this, I know the coaches and his teammates all expect him to come through, but not that time. Just not a good throw.
Takes the knee. It was a nail biter. It wasn't pretty, but it goes down as a victory.
It's even sweeter when you win a close game in the league because you know how hard it is. And to make that one play, that was the difference. Whew, a lot of joy in the locker room.
For Phil Simms and all the crew, Jim Nance saying so long.
We've just gotten started here, and already these guys have been handed a really difficult decision to make. Tough to go wrong with the NFL's all-time leader in touchdown passes, Peyton Manning, the perfect guy to have directing your offense. Ah, a good pick there at the free safety spot. Glover Quinn of the Lions, the NFL's leader in interceptions last season with seven. And that distinction helped earn him an invite to his first. A.J. Green of Cincinnati is the choice here, and a good one it is. Green comes off four straight 1,000-yard seasons to begin his NFL career.
Burning, burning, burning. Your feelings, position?
Definitely some options with this pick. Do you take a skill player here or get yourself some help up front? Some tough choices coming up right about now. Do you go after the best available player, or do you go after a position of need? Always a tough decision, offense or defense. It's all about finding the right balance when you're putting it. Boy, you look at a guy like this, talented, hardworking, and a great fit. What's not to like with that pick? Boy, you talk about a friendly turn of the cards. This is a great round for these guys as they get themselves a dynamic player right here. Something special, baby. Never broken by you. Still a few holes on this roster and not a lot of time left to do. Well, not too tough to see into the thought process of that pick. Yeah, maybe not the pick that's going to change this team's fortune, but he is an improvement over what they had. Yeah, this is kind of a curious one if you ask me. The talent's certainly there. I'm just not sure that we'll see the best of him in a system like this. How about that threesome? How do you throw two of those guys away? Maybe a little bit of a surprise selection there. Out of the three options, I'm not so sure that this was the way to go. And this is a big piece of the puzzle right here. Maybe a no-brainer, but a great pick regardless. Well, it's been 2 months, it's a little too much. Said the wrong thing, so she packed up and stood. Moved down to Mississippi, told her friend she never loved me. Said I wasn't nothing but a long-haired hillbilly. I'm sitting here, trying to let don't tell her you saw me. Well, if you ask about me, oh, I'm rocking, I won the lottery. Everybody's talking, money in the bank, gas in the tank, a little riding shotgun in my new Mustang. Well, if you ask about me, oh, I'm rocking. Now I ain't slipping days, I just lie. Put the record on, I'm so lonesome I can cry. I'm sitting here, drowning in a fella's worst fear. Don't tell her now. Well, if you ask about me, oh, I'm rocking, I won the lottery. Everybody's talking, money in the bank. A new era begins today. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is Draft Champions. The Bears interplay this afternoon, ready to see what they've got and how or if these pieces are gonna fit together. They'll square off here against the Washington Redskins.
This game has officially begun. Austin's got it on the return. And the tackle is made right around the 32-yard line. The Bears from the 32. Throws the pass. Almost intercepted that time. Here's the starting offense with a receiving core that can be so dangerous in a game like this. The Bears from the 32. The ball is fumbled. This one's going back the other way. The defender downs him as he's already on the ground. That makes it official. Really good field position here to start this drive. Murray, toss play here. They're just grinding away down here, inching closer to the end zone.
Well, that's what you got to do sometimes. It's hard always to think that you're going to come out and just make big plays. You got to do the dirty work, and this offense is doing it right now.
The quarterback He's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Garcon was the intended target, but the pass falls incomplete.
Keep a watchful eye today on wide receiver Pierre Garcon.
Big, strong, fast. He's everything you want in an NFL wide receiver. He is capable of taking every play and scoring a touchdown.
Goal line defense on the field. Second and goal from the two. Makes the catch in the end zone. Touchdown. And the early momentum in their favor as that touchdown puts them in front here in the first.
Oh, I love that word, momentum. The big Mo, and big Mo is on their side. That is a great thing to have and a good feeling as a football team.
Austin's got it. Just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line.
The Bears offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim. But you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
The hit knocks the ball out incomplete.
Take a look at the defense now. John Beeson, a player we should be calling many times today.
Yeah, he's a smart player. There's no doubt about that. And he can diagnose the runs and get in there and make those tackles. And, of course, the other thing he does, he knows how to cover the tight end and get there.
Shaq Thompson wraps up the quarterback.
You know, outside linebackers, they're everything all in one. They got to be a pass rusher, a pass cover guy, and they got to be able to stop the run. Nice job that time getting the sack.
Looking across the middle. Smith's going to pull in the bullet pass. The Bears believe they can pick up the first in this short yardage situation and keep the offense on the field.
We'll just spike it right here.
No, wait, it's a fake spike, and they're going to throw.
The Bears go for it on fourth down, and they do not get it done. Now it's up to their defense to bail them out.
Loss of five on the play. The Redskins offense coming back onto the field. It was a good drive for them last time they had it, all the way down to the end zone for the touchdown.
Yeah, you know, in this game, Jim, it's all about momentum. And when you feel you got the momentum on your side, you got to take advantage of it. So now I think it's up to the offensive coordinator to call the right plays.
This defense today will rely heavily on Ray Maluga.
Yeah, Ray Maluga just has such energy on the field. Plays all out, smart, knows where to go. Great qualities for a linebacker.
This defense is ready to pounce here early in this game as a third and long play is coming up.
They sure are. There's no doubt about that. They got themselves in a good situation here. If I'm the quarterback now, third and long, I would be very cautious and conservative.
Touchdown, Redskins.
They've built up a nice lead, and we're still only midway through the first quarter.
Jim, it is a good lead midway in the first quarter, and wow, the offense is hot. The quarterback, everybody playing well right now, and I don't know what's going to stop them.
The Redskins getting ready for the kickoff. Takes it from the four, and here we go. And they stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. Manning's got no one behind him. Just a quarterback waiting for the snap. The Bears with an empty backfield look here. Pulls it in.
That was a nice job by the offense. It just puts them in a better position. Nice little throw and catch.
Second and six coming up. Two tight ends on the field here. The Bears have it at the 24. And it's knocked down.
Well, when there's man-to-man coverage on the defensive side, and the defense does a job like this where they are covering those receivers, there is nothing a quarterback can do except that throw another incomplete pass.
Manning's going to take it from the gun. He'll throw it over the middle. The Bears not punting. Going to go for it on fourth down. The Bears will look to get to the 29 to pick up a first. The Bears take it from the 23. Green's there to catch a ball that had a lot of heat on it. Now they take the football onto the opponent side of the field. The Redskins defense has to be demoralized by that fourth down conversion allowed.
I think any time on the defensive side when you give up a fourth down conversion, it is heartbreaking, and it has to be heartbreaking for the defense right now.
Has his man. Gaines, 17.
Oh, I loved it when I was a quarterback, throwing screens or throwing short passes to the running backs and watch them catch it and get those big yards. It was awesome to get cheap yards like that.
First down at the 32. Reaches out and snatches it. He's brought down at the 20-yard line.
If they're going to take away all the receivers down the field, throw it short to your running back and look what they can do in the open field. Nice run by the running back.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Smith's got it. Touchdown, and that'll close the gap in this one. I know it's just the first quarter, Phil, but they needed that touchdown. This team was in danger of possibly being embarrassed today.
Oh, the way they were playing, they were getting dominated on offense and defense, and all of a sudden, you look up and boom, a quick score by them, and they're right back in it.
Just can't hold on that time. They failed to convert on the two-point try, so they'll just have to settle for the six. The Redskins ready to return the kick. Royals got a chance to return this one. Taken down at the 39. That return is good for about 27. The Redskins ready to go on the march again, and that's exactly what they've been doing here lately. They've taken it all the way down the field over the last two possessions for touchdowns. Phil, can they make it three straight?
Let me say this to you, Jim. It's just not that easy. As we're watching this game and how they're playing on the offensive side, they make it look easy, but trust me, I was down there one time. It's a hard job.
Redskins have it at the 39. Launching it deep. Makes the play. That's another reception. Give him two.
That's a big game by the offense, and that's what this league is about. We talk about so many things. Oh, play good defense, don't turn it over. But it's about big plays. You got to take chances down the field. The quarterback was willing to do it that time, and he made it happen.
The Redskins still possess the football as we begin the second quarter. Snapping the football from the 28. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. Gaines, 17.
When you play man-to-man against this receiver, you're going to have a tough time. Quarterback's a good thrower. Really hard for a defense to back to stay with him.
What a catch. Touchdown. Their lead grows a little more with that touchdown, and still a long way to go in this half. They may be able to add even more to it before the break.
Jim, I don't see anything that's going to slow them down. Everything they are trying is working. They have been spectacular here so far today, and all I can say to the opponents, you better buckle up. This is going to be tough.
Austin will test the coverage. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line.
the Bears preparing to get things going again on offense. They took it all the way on their previous possession, mostly getting it done through the air.
Yeah, they got the lead. That quarterback, he takes control of the situation when he goes out on the field. And I know that defense, they had great respect for him. Now they fear him. That's a tough spot to be in on the defensive side.
First down at the 22. Throws the pass. Forte's got the catch and the first. The Bears step up to the line, employing now their jumbo package. Looking to go up top again on first down. And Williams can't hold on that time.
Williams is going to be so mad at himself for dropping that football, because receivers, you never know when your chance is going to come. And then finally, you get open, they call a play where you're the primary guy. It's right there, and you drop it. Well, don't get down on yourself. Stay up. The football will come your way again.
The Bears from the 37. Smith's got it on a pass that had some heat. Smith's marked down at the 34. The Bears trail right now, but the passing game has been strong. Manning's having a big day.
When you see an offense working like this, it's kind of exciting. I know the fans are really behind it. There's nothing like watching a quarterback who's really got it going, throwing the football down the field, and his guys catching it. Does it take talent to do something like this? You've got to time the pass, where the football's going, where the receiver's going to catch it, and do the perfect timing. Get that receiver, and that football comes flying out. Nice job that time. Incomplete pass.
They're going to run it on the toss.
Breaking huddle at the 35-yard line.
The Bears lined up, bunch formation. The Bears come to the line. The first down marker is at the 24. On the money. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
Good job by the defense. Staying in the right spots. They give up the short pass. They make the tackle. And now we have fourth down coming up.
We've hit the two-minute warning here in the first half. And this will be a 50-yard field goal try. And it's a fake field goal. Brandon Pettigrew with the catch. Touchdown!
How about that? The fake field goal, the holder, fakes it, gets up, and puts the football right on the money for the touchdown.
The Bears for the extra point kick. Inside of the uprights. The Redskins ready to return the kick. Royals got it. And he's tackled just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. First down at the 22. Looking across the middle. Locked in on the football. And he's in the clear. The 20. Taking it all the way home for the touchdown.
Another touchdown throw by the quarterback here in the half. And look, this guy is flat slinging that football today. There's no wonder. It doesn't matter. He needs a little small window. He can fit it in there. He is on fire.
The Bears are ready to return the kick. And And this is Ginn running it out.
Shakes off the tackle. Twists away from the hit.
And they crash into him, ending the return at the 20-yard line.
The Bears on a quest for their third straight scoring drive here, Phil. They've been having their way with that defense on these last few possessions.
Well, let me say this, Jim. It's not that easy to score points in the NFL. Not the way they're making it look. And they're confident. They look like they're fast, they're fresh, they're rested. It's been fun to watch.
Not able to get away from Chancellor. First down here.
You know, when you're catching the football, there's nothing like catching the pass, whether it's short or long, and breaking a tackle and getting a couple of extra yards. That makes the quarterback have some confidence in you, and he'll start looking for you more.
Manning's completion percentage, 60% on the day. Let's see how they back up the big play here. Manning out of the gun. Close the gap.
Well, we're talking about some of the fastest humans on earth. And we take into account you can't touch them or breathe on them. That's how they're able to get open and make so many catches.
Extra point was good.
The Bears setting up here for the kickoff.
Got a flag.
The kicker just couldn't keep it in bounds there.
The Redskins will look to get set. Been a close game so far. The scores 28-20.
First down at the 40.
Going to take it the distance.
The 10. And he's in for the touchdown. What a play. What a run.
The receivers in the NFL are so talented now. Not surprised to see another touchdown catch by this guy today. He has it all. Size, speed, great hands. Nice catch.
You talk about momentum. That turns into an 8-point trip, the touchdown and the two.
This offense and the head coach and the offensive coordinator, they're all aggressive. So, hey, well, it's not good enough just to get a touchdown. They want to get that extra point or 2 points. Nice job that time.
Bill Markham at the 22. That returns good for about 22.
The Bears bring their offense back onto the field. Touchdown drive the last time they had it as they attacked that secondary.
They sure did. They threw the football well on that last drive. And now I would think as an offensive coordinator, they're thinking pass on the defensive side. Switch it up. And I think you can catch them with some good runs here.
The Bears come out in a jumbo set. First down at the 22. He runs with it right up the gut.
Good job by the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
They went with the ground game on first down, bringing up second. Peyton Manning from the shotgun. Forte's got it on a pass, had some heat on it.
When you get aggressive safeties, you like to get up there and try to stop the run. The post route is an awesome way to take advantage of that. Go down the field, 10 to 12 yards, plant that outside foot, run towards the goalpost. Nice throw by the quarterback.
And that pass is going out of bounds, incomplete. The first half is complete. Larry Ridley is ready to take things over back in our studios. And you're watching the NFL on EA Sports. The second half kickoff is a comeback in the cards tonight. He'll dip out of bounds. That return's good for about 18. The Redskins offense takes the field. Let's see if this momentum can carry over from the first half, because they have been brilliant to this point, partner.
Yeah, a lot of things change in that locker room at halftime. You know, you might feel good about what you've done. Of course, you got to realize the defense might be upset and is willing to come out here and take more chances in the second half.